chances are pretty good in game seven.
When you look at the goaltenders in this series, you look at Jonathan Quick first, and you can see it's pretty obvious why he's so hard to beat. He's so quick, so athletic. When you look at Anthony Emme, it's not as obvious. Why is it that he's so effective?
His work ethic. It's outstanding the way he never quits on a play. He gets back in the crease. He doesn't come out a whole lot and challenge the shooters. He's a stay-at-home type of goaltender who stays there on the line. He comes up with a couple saves early on in this one. A pretty agile guy, too, though. He doesn't have too many troubles getting his feet across to make some big saves. I thought that L.A. peppered him early in this game. Once San Jose had taken the lead, they battled to try to get it evened up there. Clifford gets stopped by Niemi. They tried different ways to try to beat him. A little flip shot here from Justin Williams. He's in good position to make that save. There's a lot to like about the way that he tends goal.
Niemi doesn't seem to be the type of guy that gets rattled at all, that, you know, gets frustrated, or let's just put it this way. He doesn't really get emotional on the ice. Jonathan Quick, we're seeing him maybe lose his cool once in a while.
Yeah.
When we go into a game seven, is there a message that has to be sent to Jonathan Quick?
I don't know if somebody sent the message. Keith talked about it earlier in the show, where Jonathan Quick really reacted in game four and started to get busy with face washes and hacking at people. Even on one particular goal, was the pass from Thornton. Who got that?
Gagliardi kind of had stick on him.
He had a little whack on him, and that distraction is not good if you're a goaltender. Tonight we saw it again. He got clipped, his legs got clipped, and all of a sudden that sent him into a bit of a rage, even threw a puck at somebody, at Couture. That won't work. Somebody's going to have to remind him that that's not, the focus is just to stop the puck. But he's so competitive, a little of that's okay, but you can't lose it.
If he gets clipped, does someone on his team have to go after that person?
You can't when the score is 2-1, and that's been the issue, right? The score in the game has been one-goal games. All three San Jose wins at home have been one-goal games. These are back in games 3 and 4. Gagliardi clipped him a couple of times. Burns bumped him. More traffic to the front of the net here. A couple of punches. This is what Mike's talking about. Mm-hmm. It can't happen. You don't want that from your goaltender. The time and the score have a lot to do with the way that Quick has reacted. There's Couture. There should have been a penalty.
Exactly. It should have been a penalty, and I don't know why it hasn't been enough. If I'm Daryl Sutter, I'm all over this stuff. I don't think they've made enough noise about this, and I don't care if they're accused of whining or what. That's a penalty, and that's a, it's also a strategy that's been employed by the San Jose Sharks, and God bless them, it's working a little bit, but it's got to be brought to the attention of the officials.
Quick didn't get the call. He didn't get the win. The Sharks got it, and it went to Anthony Emme. Niemi, 24 saves on the night. The Sharks win it 2-1. The series is all tied at 3 games apiece. We're back after this.